Oh, and welcome back to another round of Forgotten Hope 2 on Mirth River in MacPolo's squad. And we are the Waffen SS advancing during, well, kind of like a fictionalized version of Wacht am Rhein, I guess, where we reached the Mirth River. Which, damn it, of course never happened in real life. Where was the rest of the squad? Oh, wait, well, apparently it's a tank squad, never mind. You know, we could have been quicker on foot. Just saying. Oh, he's on foot, but he's coming from the fucking main base. Why? Now they have the flag. Oh well. That Pakistan guy is still doing that AK-47 trolling thing. And my squad leader got run over by some idiot. This is starting great. Almost as bad as the real Ardennes offensive. It's interesting, many people think the Ardennes offensive was this big, like, mechanized assault. It basically, like, the initial breakthrough was basically throwing infantry divisions at it, like in World War I. Was literally a World War I type assault. Artillery barrage sent in the infantry. Only difference being that they gave almost every infantryman in these Volksgrenadier divisions an SDG-44, but, well, that doesn't really win you a battle. And then they wanted to send through the mechanized divisions, but it didn't work, because the infantry got swamped. In the end they had to commit the panzers too early, and the whole timetable was off. Was one of the most badly planned attacks ever, seriously. By the way, it's Sunday now, and right on target my my internet keeps spazzing out. Like, what? I'm really beginning to think it's because of overload, because too many people are actually using the internet on the weekend. I mean, that's my theory. Which would really annoy me. I mean, at least I'm using the internet for something good. The rest are just using it to watch porn, complaining about refugees on Facebook. Why is that guy always on there? It would be nice to get some reinforcements here. The problem also at the beginning of the Wacht am Rhein offensive was that the Volksgrenadier division were supposed to have armored support in the form of Stuks or Hetzers, and many of them were never arrived or got stuck in the mud and so on. The whole mess, that thing. And many people are like, oh yeah, they almost overran the American army. No, they didn't. They overran like one division and mauled a few, and that was it. Never really had any chance to succeed. The whole thing was a mess. Am I the only one here? From my squad, I mean. Although I guess and the squad leader is on the wrong side of the river. I think they're attacking over there. In case you didn't notice, I did read a lot of books about the Ardennes offensive recently. Oh, I already wasted my nade apparently. Yeah. Where did he go? That's actually an American. God, have to love the SDG-44. Now, talking about the Ardennes offensive, one thing that struck me is that the SDG-44 wasn't actually very rare during the Ardennes offensive. And I think it was even less rare than some people might think. Like, there are so many, if you read, like, eyewitness accounts, there are so many references to Germans with, you know, machine pistols and so on. I think, especially from the American side, burp guns, they often say, I think they often refer actually to SDG-44s that were used by Volksgrenadier divisions in the first waves en masse. Never had French in school, only Latin. No, an SS division like this probably also had a few, but not like whole platoons equipped with them, like a Volksgrenadier division. I mean, for example, if you look at the pictures, the famous pictures from that ambush at, where was that, Poteau, I think, where they ambushed that American column, the SS troops, you can see the squad leader has an SDG-44, the rest apparently just rifles, including sometimes captured American ones, although I guess it was probably for the film cameras. There's also this famous picture of a paratrooper riding on one of the Kampfgruppe Piper tanks that had a Sten gun for him somewhere. Probably from Holland. So if we ever do like a Kampfgruppe Piper and Fallschirmjäger map, like Stomont map or something, that could be like a nifty Easter egg pickup kit, Sten gun. I'm always up for that kind of thing. And yeah, I know the squad leader wants to attack over there, but to be honest, it's not like he's anywhere near it or the squad is even cohesive. And I think at this stage, it might be good to defend this. Because I am hearing maybe a transport or something. I did hit somebody. Yeah, got an assist point. That's an American, one second. He will appear here. And I would suck. But spray and pray carries the day. It actually rhymes, we should put that on like a calendar. I'm so good right now, I don't know why. So now that I said that, I will do something incredibly stupid. Watch. No, I thought he was camping in there. Almost shot at our Panzerfaust kit. Wonder, should I use the Panzerfaust for something? Yes, I know I should. Ugh, these guys. Easily outmaneuvered. Ah, shit, they captured it. Need reinforcements, guys, please? Maybe, a little bit? What the fuck? He just did. He just kept walking. Ah, shit, I saw that coming, but too late. Yeah, see, and now he's up there in God knows where, and they attacked here. I totally saw it coming, mate. But fuck it. Squad leader, then. Ah, he's in a tank. Also known as Death Traps. What's he even doing here? I mean, I'm not a tanker, but this seems to be a weird tactic. See, don't spawn on tanks. They just attract fire. But see, this is why, sometimes I just want to kick some ass in this game. Yeah, it happens. This is why I said earlier that this is kind of like a fictionalized version of the Ardennes offensive. For example, the tank that just killed ours was a Jumbo with a 76mm gun, which was a conversion that was done in 1945, actually. And sometimes, and I hope, maybe I will bring that up to some dev who can code it, but in real life they also often had the anti-aircraft 50 cal put in as a coaxial machine gun, so you would have a 50 cal in the turret. That could be kind of cool. To be honest, I could have been an American. No, okay. To be honest, I kind of would like to see somebody shit. There's more Americans here, I can smell it. That's an American. I would kind of like somebody, maybe one of the better custom mappers, to make a proper late war American map, like Cedar Heights time frame with the late war stuff. Could be cool. I'm thinking, what's it called? I'm thinking Paderborn or something like that. Ruhr pocket. T-step. Okay. Like, I know somebody, I just saw that on the PR forum, somebody from the PR World War II mod made a map based on Kassel, where I actually live, interestingly enough. And there were some battles around there, especially around Paderborn, with lots of heavy tanks, because the Henschel-Werke tank factory is in Kassel, or was in Kassel, of course. Today it's the university where I studied. So you could have King Tigers, Jagd Tigers, all the good stuff. Oh, yeah, I didn't see that coming. I thought they would be upstairs, so to speak. Oh, I dig loads. You know what a cloter is? A cunt. Oh, he was killed. The thing is, even if I had killed him now in revenge, I would not have gloated. Because I'm not a cunt. I'm an asshole. Sometimes I'm an idiot. I'm dangerously incompetent, but I'm not a cunt. That's kind of a boring state of affairs. Now, the clever thing would probably to advance towards their main base to rape them, but to be honest, I kind of want to leave that to others. Apparently lots of allied AFKs. Now the spamming Spanish guys. Spamish. Already at work again. Now let's go over to my squad. You know that we finally have some cohesion going. Oh, that's an American here. He is dead. Could have been exciting. Yeah, so now they're all running towards the OOB line. No, we'll be over soon. What the fuck are you doing, mate? You go down. Oops. Yeah, see the legs. Yeah. The worms, I don't really like fighting in this forest area. It's too chaotic for me. Too many angles. Too many sneaking around bitches. Too many tanks rolling over. They're actually driving the Panther into the OOB line. Yeah, teams are stacked. That's actually one of ours. Luckily, I don't shoot so well. So, talking more about the Ardennes offensive, I guess. Well, formal it is then. Now, one thing I found weird is recently I read somewhere, or not recently, like a few months ago, I read somewhere that actually during the first day of the Ardennes offensive there wasn't really any snow. But now I'm reading, like, witness accounts where they say it was snowy right from the start. So if anybody can shed some light on that, do you know what was the case and whatnot? I would really be interested in that. Attacking. Can you get up here? No. Didn't really look like it, actually. Okay. Throwing nades uphill, always dangerous. What the fuck? That was the assault tank. What? Dude. There's three Americans up there at least, and I kill the two Germans. What the fuck? Like, there's one. There's the German. What the fuck's going on here? Is that some fraternization going on? Are you fucking incompetent? Don't you realize there's an American among you? I thought there was a full fucking American squad up here. I mean, seriously. Although I should have looked at the stupid minimap, but... Where's that machine gunner? There! You saved us there. But yeah, that was weird. There was one American and they didn't move. Like... Anyway, we won. Hope you enjoyed it. As always, thanks for watching. Have a nice day.